1,000 years ago, Jacob Frederick's ancestors came from South America to settle the islands of the Caribbean. Setting off from the Orinoco Delta in great ocean-going canoes, they paddled a vast distance in search of new lands. The islands they found were a paradise of natural resources. They called themselves Calinago, but Europeans would give them a new name, the Caribs. The first appearance of the word Carib in recorded history is found in a letter home from Columbus to Ferdinand and Isabella. Canibales, Columbus called them, introducing this new word to the languages of Europe and forever forging the image of Caribs as warlike man-eaters. 5 centuries of European colonization followed, and the Caribs fought to protect their way of life. It was a desperate struggle for survival, in the end leaving only a trace. Today, centuries later, Jacob Frederick wonders about his ancestors. Who were they? Can he find them?
Ancestors believed there were two things, either you were bad or you good. We believe in Mabuya and Manitou. Manitou is good and Mabuya is bad. So either there was no really good belief that you could follow both. You could follow either one or the other, and that is exactly what the Christian people brought it to us as well. At the same time, when they brought this cross and tell us, they brought Christ and tell us to do things good, they were stealing from us. When he said that there were inhabitants already, that he could manipulate them, they were easy to be Christianized, they were easy to do anything. At the same time, he was telling him, well, you should not fight back. Don't fight back. And he must succumb to whatever I tell you to do. And that is why they call us savages, because we fought back.
The island of Dominica was a natural place for the Caribs to survive. Its wind-swept peaks and impenetrable rainforests sheltered the Caribs from centuries of European persecution. Today, Dominica remains home to the last stronghold of Caribs living in the Caribbean. They have survived, but only a few thousand remain. With their language and culture all but wiped out, Dominica's Caribs are just a small, voiceless minority living on a reservation at the fringe of Caribbean life.
My dream to build this canoe was since I was a young boy. Growing up, I figured out, well, maybe one day I'll do something to fight back. I really wanted to fight back. Then this idea came out to me that we should build the canoe and sail it back.
A voyage back to the Caribs' ancestral homeland in South America. But with no resources to make such a journey, Jacob's dream lived only in his paintings. In August of 1994, a new face came to the Carib Reserve. Aragorn Dick Reed, an artist and student of tribal crafts, come to learn about the culture and history of the Caribs.
What's this white guy doing here? Who is this guy?
I'm not naturally from here, as you can tell. I mean, my family stock is from Europe, from England. But I'm born in these parts and I've chosen to live in these parts. And so I think it's important to find out the best ways to live in these parts.
I came up one day and met that sick boy there walking down the road. I said something, stopped the truck and asked him, "Where is he going to?" He said, "Caribs there." She said, "That's where he went to go to." So he came up.
Military.
He just came in and stopped talking. And I mean, they're just friends at the beginning, first friends, you know.
Before long, Jacob's dream to build a canoe captured his new friend's imagination.
Like minds thinking alike, really. Jakey had in his mind a long time to be making canoes. His father made them, and he obviously wanted to make one too. Eh? And I had in my mind to make canoes from a different angle. I mean, just from growing up with my father's pictures of him in Africa and seeing canoes, and then from my studies, seeing the use of canoes in tribal societies.
The idea that I want to re-establish connection with my people, and the arrogant idea of building a canoe and sail it, that just coincide. And we're not trying to prove anything. We're just repeating something to re-establish connections with our people.
To build their dream canoe, Jacob and Aragorn appealed to a legendary master boat builder among the Caribs, known as Charlo. Under Charlo's leadership, a group of Caribs, along with visitors from 15 countries, venture into the hills over the Carib Reserve.
Stand by here.
Okay, stand by. We're keeping going up.
To construct a vessel fit for the high seas, Charlo must guide the crew to a gommier tree of massive proportions, one that can only be found in the most remote part of the forest. The special tree chosen by Charlo is, by his estimate, twice as old as himself, 120 years, give or take a few.
I've gone to the different places and seen canoes being built. And Charlo takes pride in building his canoes, man. Charlo is an artist of his own taste, you know?
I would say Charlo is, he's the magician, you know? He's, every village has him. And when it comes to canoes, he's the master magician.
Following Charlo's lead, the crew will have to live and work for weeks in the bush to transform the fallen log.
We're not pretending to make a canoe from the 1490s. No way. I mean, the technique of canoe building is resilient, it's strong, it's overcome all the ages, it's overcome the other clinker-built boats that were introduced by Europeans.
A week's work has made the first dent in the log, a flat, exposed platform, ready for the next stage to begin.
Okay.
going to cut the outside. We have to leave a kill there.
Yeah.
From there, we go right through there.
A shallow works, a technique passed down through the ages, is revealed.
That's your line now, right now. You have to learn SD.
Yeah, well, is that you have to learn to make it all over there?
Yeah.
That's the first time I'm going to see somebody. Really? About, eh?
Really?
Yeah.
Me too.
So that's a shift, sir.
The inner stem of the palm frond has a natural arc that provides the shape for the boat's prow. Traced one way, then the reverse, it yields a shape of unmistakable symmetry. Weeks pass. The log seems unyielding.
I believe to me he's feeling weak. Is why he's taking a little rest.
Humor and resourcefulness will be the crew's only tools against the monotony and the daily challenges of bush life. It's difficult to imagine that the ancient Caribs did this with only fire and stone tools. But the gradual emergence of the canoe's shape inspires a much-needed rebirth of energy. The carved vessel weighs roughly 3 tons, and more than 2 miles of tangled forest now stand between her and the sea. The task might seem impossible, but a strong cooperative tradition will bring reinforcements from the Carib Reserve to help bring the canoe down.
Again, we have a little problem because we got stuck between two trees. And that gives us a little problem here at the moment. But I think we'll make it through.
Control in front of me. Come on, I do fine.
After 2 grueling days, the Pegua River at the forest's edge is a welcome sight.
It's like she could go to sea now.
It's so I believe.
So, huh?
Yeah.
So when she's ready, she's going to be real strong.
For sure.
Do you think she could reach the Orinoco?
Yeah.
You coming with us?
Are you ready?
You're captain?
Yeah.
Cool.
celebration in the Carib Reserve. But work remains to be done. The canoe now enters the final phase of construction. First, she will be fired, a process using fire, rocks, and water to warp the wood and open the canoe outward. Over months, this will cause the canoe to grow more than a meter in width. Structural frames and a full-length plank on each side will give strength and added height to avoid swamping on the high seas. As work continues, Jacob and Aragorn plot their course. The voyage will cover more than 800 miles, following the arc of the Windward Islands southward to the coast of South America.
The journey that we've got ahead of us, we've been calling it more of a symbolic journey, a gesture to reconnect the Carib people all the way down the islands back to Guyana.
If we have, we know there are groups in St. Vincent, there are groups in Dominica, there are groups in Trinidad, there are groups in South America that can bind themselves together as a group. We will have some voice.
To man the canoe, a crew must be chosen from among the Caribs. Sebastian Frederick, a Carib farmer from the village of Celebia, be one of 8 men and 2 women selected to join the expedition.
If you would fight Jakey at school, if you had to have to fight Jakey at school, you would have to fight me. And if you have to fight me, you would have to fight Jakey. And that's how we grow together. So we always have good confidence in each other.
Seats are too low to row on. You're rowing up to your head, you should be rowing to your belly. Strip in there to raise the seats up on.
One of the aspects that we're hoping to draw up about the whole voyage is the language issue. I mean, we have a copy of the Breton Dictionary of the Carib language, which is a dictionary written by a French Jesuit that lived amongst the Caribs in the 1630s, 1640s. And he recorded as best he could the Carib language.
Nearly a year from the date of Charlot's first chop, the canoe is complete, 35 feet long, 6 feet wide, and 4 feet tall. She's called Gligli, after a hawk revered by the Caribs as a totem of bravery. With costs of the voyage mounting, Jacob and Aragorn struggle to raise funds. As Jacob gathers local crafts to be sold along the way, yes, Aragorn makes overtures to the international community.
Hello. Est-ce que c'est Jacques Bagel? Je m'excuse. Misread the 3 for 5.
Money, food, equipment, medical supplies. Donations come, but the costs are formidable. For the first time, Jacob and Aragorn face the prospect that the dream may be out of reach.
I should ask you, actually, how much does that cost? Okay. Very expensive. Okay, thanks for warning me. Bye.
A support boat, vital for the voyage, proves costly.
But it's just in our face, isn't it? Mud splat in our face.
Jacob and Aragorn consider delaying the launch until more money can be raised.
If we can't, then we'll just take a wait tax.
Hang out here in paradise.
Yeah, hang out here in Dominica.
It seems that the Oregon is getting closer. Closer every day.
The whole Oregon, that's what I'm watching.
At the 11th hour, they are saved by a dead man. Christopher Robinson was a 20th century friend and activist for the Caribs. Upon his death in 1989, he bequeathed Dominica's Caribs a sum of money intended to help restore their cultural heritage. With luck, a donation of £10,000 from the Robinson bequest is enough to ensure that the canoe will launch.
We're pretty much excited. We're pretty much, into what we're doing. After all this 2 years of hard working, and it's done, and when we finish, and we're just ready for the journey, and we know it's going to be much harder. Being on the canoe, sailing down the island, will be much harder than this 2 years of building it up anyway.
I don't worry, I just pray for him to go on his journey and to return.
Jacob's mother feels pride for her son, but hopes for his safety.
I know he'll make it by the power of the Almighty, he will make it. And I believe he will make it, and he'll make it too.
Done the best we can as far as safety gear on board. We've got, you know, two compasses and full set of life harnesses, full set of life jackets. I mean, those kind of safety factors are the best you can do, but there are all kinds of other realities that can just wipe that to pieces in a minute.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Mary, Star of the Sea, pray for us. Repeat, Mary, Star of the Sea, pray for us.
Finally, the day arrives. News of the canoe has spread throughout the territory, piquing interest and awakening a long dormant sense of tribal pride.
My ancestors traveled for many, many miles. We are going once again to travel these many miles from this beautiful land and from this beautiful shore to another land.
Be careful! You will have to keep my balance here. Have a better home now.
To begin her journey, the Gligli must face Atlantic waters before navigating the Caribbean Sea southward along the Windward Islands. Sailing behind the canoe will be the Carmela, a 120-foot schooner that will carry stores of food, equipment, and medical supplies, along with members of the support crew.
Gligli, Carmela.
The Gligli enjoys her first successful crossing, 30 miles under strong winds to the French island of Martinique.
A few priority things that I think we've got to check on. Everybody, human safety. If there's anything on board this boat that is looking dangerous, somebody point it out, okay? And we've all got to watch out for our own lives.
You know, it's not going to be a joyride. It's not going to be a joyride. I thought it's really going to be a hard, long sail.
I'm not gonna tack it. Wait till I get a
push it back. Push it back.
Okay. All right, we tack it now.
Push it.
With sunny skies and a good wind at their back, the Gligli crew fails to notice a squall rising from the east.
You're about to down the hatches here, Charlie.
Camela over. No.
With a Gleekly out of sight, panic spreads over the support boat crew.
That's a start, that would be a start. They won't be able to bail that boat with all those people in it, you know.
What?
They can't bail the boat, it's a wash.
I know, I told them, but they didn't listen. I
don't see why they all want to stay in the damn thing.
The gust of wind just came in and we had no chance of Shooting in, you know. Had no time to do anything, man. We knew definitely from the time the water kind of went underneath the water, there wasn't enough weight to bring it back up. We were just going down slowly, just very quick anyway. But there was no panic. Everybody was safe.
Baptized by fire. The Gleegly presses on, making visits to island communities along her way.
I mean, it's an educational thing for all the other islands that we meet as well. I mean, for children in schools learning about Caribs, it's going to reawaken a lot of just knowledge and awareness. You know, I think that's the crucial thing.
The idea is to revive the culture, to make the world hear and make our governments in different territories hear that, okay, these people are alive and you should treat them better than how you're treating them. And regardless of what we do, unless we tell the people that, I mean, we are there, we face extinction.
Gleegly.
Gleegly. Gleegly.
As the Gleegly continues south, word spreads throughout the Caribbean and beyond that these Caribs are on the move, no longer content to vanish into the pages of history. But meanwhile, aboard the canoe, 2 months traveling and the challenges of life at sea are beginning to take their toll.
What do you want to do? Tell me. No, I don't want to do anything. You don't want to do anything? We'll go in the front of the boat.
You tell me what to do.
Okay, I'll tell you to go in the front of the boat, please.
Right. Sorry, I'll just say, just tell me and I do it.
Okay, do it.
But when you're allowed to do it,
Jake, we can't have two of these lines on one cleat. We can't. We physically can't. Don't laugh at me, Jacob. I'm telling you the truth. That's how we've been sailing this canoe up to now. You want to laugh at my face?
Okay, Sabo. Sabo, la Maui.
With tensions mounting, the crew faces its greatest hurdle, a crossing of roughly 125 miles of open sea between Grenada and the island of Trinidad.
I told the Coast Guard that we're making our move, so they know. They saying it's 20, possibly 25 knot winds, so the wind is going to be strong.
What I should say?
Yeah, shall I?
Is the weather? The weather, you must watch the weather before you move. Yeah.
So, but if we can get up high, we'll use all that strength for our favor and get across quick.
We'll be bailing a lot.
We'll be bailing a lot. We'll be sailing a lot, man. We'll be cranking.
The crossing will last more than 30 hours, over 2 days and through a night. With only the stars to guide them, the Gleegly crew will have to cross the powerful outflow of the Orinoco Delta.
Did you have any agreement with them about...
Every hour.
During the night, radio contact is lost, and the crew aboard the support boat can only hope for the safety of the Gleegly crew. But with the sun's first rays, fears are lifted as the Gleegly's familiar sail is sighted.
Oh!
Nine miles off the coast of South America, the island of Trinidad will be the Gleegly's last stop before crossing to the mainland. Here, the crew visits Trinidad's own surviving indigenous community, fellow descendants of a shared heritage.
To our community who have come to officially welcome you and your party to Arima. I think these trips, these contacts, serve to strengthen us as descendants of the Amerindian people.
In them you admit your own flesh and blood, there's blood is thicker than water, there's always the bong in there. And that's exactly what's happening here.
Because I tell myself, if you could make that journey from Dominica to come here, I could make that journey from here to the Red House in Border Street. And I would go down a day when they have in Parliament.
As Jacob rebuilds ties with Trinidad's indigenous leaders, Aragorn prepares the crew for a new chapter.
We have to basically transform the whole operation from being a sea operation to be ready for to be a river operation. Weeds, mosquitoes, a whole different operation that we have to be ready for.
The Carmela is too large a vessel to move upriver, so the canoe will have to travel alone with just a small second boat for support. With only a limited crew able to travel upriver, tensions arise that have been building over the weeks at sea.
If anybody have something to say, don't say nothing behind your back. Say plenty in front of you.
I think there should be something better organized on this boat before we leave here in Trinidad to go on the other side. Try to get things settled down that, you know, in the beginning it was all right, but right now it seems like something different.
The plan is, as if those that haven't heard it, is that the first group that goes into the Orinoco River is going to be a much smaller group.
I want nobody to fool me. I want nobody to tell me I'm this, I'm that, I'm doing this, I'm doing that. Just tell me plain.
The river thing has to be really, really worked out. We're not going to be able to take everybody up the rivers. It seems like it's going to be difficult to get a third boat, just for the expense and just for the reality of it.
Chaos. Chaos. Well, I mean, I've watched lots of Jacques Cousteau movies and stuff on TV, you know, where they have all the nice new equipment and the Calypso and all these fancy new stuff and all the latest dive equipment. Or the exact, I mean, you can imagine the exact opposite of all that nice new stuff, you know. Completely dysfunctional. Everybody always fights and nothing works and everything's breaking down constantly. But it's almost like it should be that way. It keeps us on our toes, you know. We're always alert.
Look it over there. Look it right there.
One mile outside the Orinoco Delta, the Glee-Glee will separate from her support boat. As goodbyes are said, the crew to man the Glee-Glee up the rivers must finally be selected.
So we'll see you later. We'll see you in the Barima.
No problem.
Yeah.
Okay.
I forgot word you were losing one passenger, Aragon. Tell me what's the problem.
I can't believe your mentality that you think 5 minutes before we're going.
Listen, it's not my mentality.
It is your mentality.
Somebody came up to me and said, pack my things.
No, no, no.
You are able to go.
It's unbelievable that you didn't think to come talk to me and 5 minutes before we're leaving you say, hi, I'm coming.
I was just
No, I just can't believe it.
No!
All this last 2 weeks you've been planning on flying to Guyana or getting down there ahead of us. Then you came to me and said you can't afford the tickets. I said, stay on the Carmel and meet us in the Barima.
With tempers already frayed, a small last-minute dispute threatens to divide the crew.
I'm not going.
No, we didn't do see what earlier about the objective.
Yeah, no,
it's not.
I said, I'm going down.
I mean, who can go, but who can go?
Look, Prince staying. Look, the woman staying. Look, that
is here. I'm in pre sick. You can't go. You can't go.
Let's get on board the boat, man. I just so sick of it. It's like a bunch of children, a lot of you.
I'm not going. Well, back, I talk and I finish, I don't talk again. And it's one man, doesn't go nowhere, I'm not going. Those people doesn't go, I doesn't go.
Mm.
They come to go, yeah. All of them.
What's wrong with you? Who do you want to come?
People don't want to go, saying that they doesn't go.
Look, what is this? Some kind of collective cowardice? What is this?
They
this is some kind of unbelievable reality.
Let's walk together.
Oh, yeah?
And then you hurt one, you hurt all.
Come and
tell
me
about
them. And how about you hurting one me right now?
Nobody cannot hurt more than one another. One another. Everybody have to go. And that's all.
That's a fucking word to me for the rest of the time. Get in the road. Tell her she's coming now. Should we go? We're going. The Orinoco's got one of the biggest outflows of water in the world of any river. We, funnily enough, choosing to go up against it. It's possible, but it's just hard. You know, we've got to be ready for some strong currents coming against us. But that's where I know the benefit of a canoe will be there on our side. You know, the canoe is designed for going up and down rivers and will overcome currents.
Battling upstream, the canoe and her support boat will face the new challenges of river travel. Alternately sailing, paddling, and motoring as conditions demand, they will cross eastern Venezuela before diverting to smaller arteries. The Moruca, Guahine, Barima, and Pomeroon rivers, ancient routes once paddled by the ancestral Caribs as they first took to sea. As the Glee probes deeper into Guyana's interior, expectation and curiosity rise amongst the crew. Who will we find? What will they be like? What will they think of us? After more than 800 miles of sea and river, the canoe has reached her destination, the Carib settlement at Santa Monica on Guyana's Pomeroon River. For Jacob and his fellow travelers, first fears are met by a warm welcome from Guyana's Carib community.
The whole Gligli andate Dominica Waria, Wakakaloko. Enters the Gligli from Dominica into our history.
W-E-L-C-O-M-E.
Welcome.
On behalf of the Guyanese Organization of Indigenous Peoples, it is with my greatest pleasure that I now extend to Mr. Jacob Frederick and his team warmest welcome to Kabakaburi.
Aragon! Shalom!
We sing so holy Mary, the people feel so happy. I get a girl to marry. After the show, they call me to meet the village captain. But the girl in the corner,
I wish they could never go back.
Wachili Dashika, Wachili Dashika, Wachili Dashika.
The festivities last a whole day and through the night.
I am indeed very happy. We have with us our fellow brothers from Dominica. Here we can meet as Caribs. Here we share our oneness.
Well, now the village council fixing the ceremony. I say I got no money and I can't care nobody. But they say they will help me and they will give me money. But the girl is...
With the light of day, the real work of reunion begins. After centuries of separation, there's much catching up to do.
Every night we listen through the radio news how far the boat is. When we do hear that, so that was the black Caribs from Dominica. I think they were real, real black Caribs. Some of the people get so afraid of here. Some they get frightened, so that how they frighten black people. Sometimes they might eat them like cannibals.
Seeing them and seeing us, they are the same. And maybe they might or they might not accept us as Caribs because we are mixed breed for sure. I mean, we come to, if you're bred Caribs, then we are completely different. What I want to do is to meet with the people and tell them exactly how I feel and think things should work within our peoples.
We live in the 20th century, we're not living in 1493 any longer in the 20th century, so we need to be modernized as well. That doesn't mean living our traditional culture. It just means traditional culture can live side by side with modern technology. You can have your TV, you can have your engine, you can have your airplane. At the same time, you practice your culture and traditions.
Over many days, crafts are shared. Stories are told, and issues are addressed.
Sort of opposite. So the word son is actually the word father. Yeah.
Of highest priority is the research into the Carib language.
And how do you call it?
if the language spoken today by Guyanese Caribs is the same as that recorded in Dominica in the 1600s, this will be proof of the tribe's shared heritage and a rallying cry to bring back the Carib language to Dominica.
We have grandma in North too.
Just establish that the Carib recorded in Dominica for the word sun, like...
It is comparing.
It is comparing to Imu.
The actual changeover from the sea to the river was one of the happiest ones for me. I mean, just the fact that the concept of the canoe came out of the river, went up to the islands,
right,
and then comes back into the river. And then,
the radical world economy, I mean, we ourselves have already sailed by land, by river, by sea, just been sailing all around by truck.
already talking on the next trip, man.
For sure.
we name the canoes, we plan the route.
Before long, the Gleegly and her crew will return to Dominica, but with much achieved. It has been a homecoming 500 years in the making. As twilight falls, the Gleegly again fulfills her promise to bring Caribs together. This time as a ferry service, bearing the ancestral cousins safely to their homes along the river. But the Gleegly's work is far from done. Already, plans are underway to reintroduce the Carib language in Dominica's Carib school.
We were stuck in Jackie and I, but this idea of getting some kind of a little art school, an art center together, a place, a center that Caribs can teach Caribs craft, Caribs can teach outsiders craft, and vice versa all the way around, just make it a people place.
A second voyage is planned for the coming year. A mixed crew of Caribs from Dominica and Guyana will travel to Belize to reunite with the more than 50,000 Caribs living there.
What I'm doing is going to be helping them traditionally and culturally. My children are feeling somewhat proud, you know, that I am able to do something, that they can stand up one day and say, okay, regardless of what is the outcome, but at least my dad did try.
King Mac- Great.